Good morning, praise the Lord. Today, May 27th, we'll talk about three categories of people that Paul talked about. In 1 Corinthians 2:14, he says, the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God. Actually, it'll be good if you can read the whole passage from 2:14 to 3:4, third chapter, fourth verse. Paul divided people into three categories based on how they receive the revelation of the cross by the Spirit. First is the natural man. His spirit is not lit, doesn't have regeneration, and he doesn't understand the things of the Holy Spirit of God. He can't experience the Holy Spirit since he thinks that it is foolishness. We can call him an atheist. Since he does not have the Spirit, he can't understand God's ways. He causes divisions among men. It's written in Jude 19, and he is dead with sin, according to Ephesians 2:1. Then we'll talk about the carnal man. Carnal man, he's regenerated but lives much like the unregenerate. He behaves as if he doesn't know God. He is lit, but his wick is burned down. He is a believer with childish ways, as seen in a jealous and sectarian spirit. He is an immature Christian and lives more for human opinion than for Christ. He needs the word of God for spiritual growth. Paul calls him a milk-drinking child not growing to eat solid food. He needs the Holy Spirit wisdom given by Holy Spirit and revelation, and read the word of God continuously. This carnal man's mind is set on things of the flesh. He does not submit to God's law, and so he can't please God. Third variety is the spiritual man. He is regenerated and has spiritual maturity, as seen in freedom from sectarian strife, has a nature that responds to the truth, and unbelievers find him difficult to understand. He will have the heart of Jesus, and as he is lit, he'll try to light the lives of others who are in darkness. He's having a continuous supply of the spiritual food because of his connection with the Word and the Holy Spirit. They are sons of God. This spiritual man's mind is set on things of the Spirit. They have life because they are made righteous, and they have peace because they submit to God's law. They are dead to sin and they belong to the Spirit. They are God's children. We have to realize that both carnal and spiritual men are there in the church. We all belong to either carnal or spiritual beings. So as we grow spiritually, we have to leave behind all our fleshly ways. Then only we'll be able to grow spiritually. Let's pray. Lord, please help us to grow into spiritual people. In Jesus' precious name I ask. Amen.